Hello guys, and in this video I'm gonna tell you what did we use the old newspapers for in Soviet Russia. And first we did like hats against the sun on when we were laying down or chilling on the beach. When I was a child I saw it very rarely, but in Soviet times it was very common. And also we used newspapers for as a fan, and especially grannies, they still use it, like, you know, when you ride in a train and they say don't open the window, it's like I don't want to get sick, but they feel hot and they do like this and smell in all the car wagon. Newspapers also were used as book covers to protect books, to save them for longer, because USSR was the most reading nation in the world, if you didn't know. And also it's very simple to make this like book cover, and also to hide some secret books, you know, because in USSR it was a big censorship. So if you got some prohibited book, I don't know, from the West, or I don't know about life in the West, you could cover it like that, so nobody see what this book about, like, and you can read it maybe even in metro. And in Soviet Russia it was common, and still common in nowadays Russia, to put newspapers on the wall before you stick wallpapers. Can you see it? It's old Soviet newspapers here. So walls of Soviet apartments hold like tremendous amount of history, you know. For example, here we can see like some quote from Soviet newspaper, like, demonstrators walked on the streets of Amsterdam protesting against USA aggression in Vietnam. I put so many newspapers on walls. We do it to kinda make the wall straight, you know, because walls are not have some defects sometimes, you know. So you put newspapers and wall become like straight. Also, newspapers were used even after collapse of the Soviet Union to clean windows. You can't believe how many windows in my grandfather's cars I cleaned. Like, he had like Lada cars and Moskvich car. So you just clean, and then when you clean it with like some water, then you have to do it again to remove like water, you know, and signs of like a cleaning agent or something like that, and you just do, and it's never good enough. Only when your parents or grandparents just wants to eat, to go home, they say okay, just leave it like that, but it's never good enough. And if you notice annoying fly which wants to eat your soup, for example, you can use like a newspaper as a weapon. I mean, just like, oh, this fly, you know. But I think it's international, it's not like only Soviet. By the way, I'm afraid to hit this wall because ventilation bars fall recently, because I have a vibration from trains here in the building. Also, newspapers were used for packing stuff. For example, you had like salami, and you pack it and go to work, you know, to eat it at work, because plastic didn't really exist in USSR. So then like apple, for example, but also, you know, Christmas decorations, Christmas like balls, you know, it's very common to put like Christmas balls to newspaper. Unfortunately, I don't have it in this apartment, but believe me, at my home all Christmas balls packed in newspapers, probably from 90s. Also like glasses, but like when you move to another apartment, for example, but this is international, I think. But you know, you can lauch, but it's more ecological because you use one newspaper for like not just litter it. And nowadays the world refuse plastic, you know, and turns to paper and stuff. So USSR were like more ecological in this case. Also, when you make repairs in your apartment, you always put newspapers on the walls and stuff, or like windows, so people, strangers, don't look at your window, you know. But I also put newspapers against the sun because I'm from St. Petersburg, we have white nights here, and sun didn't let me sleep for like few years until we decided this problem in the morning, you know. Sun can go up like at 2 a.m. in the morning, so I put with newspaper all window. And yeah, you put newspaper here, but I think it's international when you're making repairs. I also like cut my nails on newspaper. If you wet your shoes in the rain, for example, you just take newspaper, like, and you know, just put it there, and your shoes will dry like faster. Also, we did it, we do it putting newspapers into the shoes, for example, or into hats, but I mean like real hats, to save the form. You know, like a form rubber nowadays in shops they put to save a form. So, for example, this is winter shoes, we put newspapers there and they save their form, you know. And after, in the next year, you can wear it again. And yeah, almost forgot. Also, the reason why you put like newspapers in clothes, because that insect, like who flies, called mole. Yeah, you know, the fly who eats clothes, you know, and live like in these closets and stuff. So you, this insect is afraid of paint which you type letters, you know. So they are afraid of smell of newspapers. That's why you put paper. And by the way, Putin's nickname, by some rumors in the internet, was a mole. But it's not a bad nickname, as some of you could think. You know, in that Putin was a spy, so like in spying world, mole is someone who spy like in another country secretly and stuff like that. And Putin like was a spy in Germany, so maybe that's why he has this nickname. So guys, if you don't have a scoop with you in Soviet Russia, we just used again newspapers, but you have to put a little bit water on the end of the newspaper so the newspaper stick to the floor, like, you know, and you won't miss any dust like which you collected, so the dust won't go under the newspaper. You see how good it works? You see? Yeah. All dust I took. It works even better than the scoop sometimes. This scoop has this like rubber in the end, but you know. And that's all. Complete cleanliness. Newspapers were also used in trash cans, trash bins, you know, to protect trash bin from like smell, and just, you know, to keep it clean. because this trash can show some views, you know. And I remember the time, even after the collapse of the Soviet Union in 90s, we used to just like a trash can without plastic bags, you know, like nowadays you put like plastic bags and just take this plastic bag and put it in the on the streets trash can. But we just took all this like trash bin and I went like that on the street and just littered it in the like neighborhood's big trash bin can. So yeah, we use newspapers like that to protect the from, you know, like liquid, no, dirtiness. And of course newspapers are used as like substitute for toilet paper. I use toilet paper only on special occasions. They're like from Soviet Union still. And yes, it's very simple to do them. So we didn't have this toilet paper crisis in Russia, deficit of toilet paper, because we use newspapers. And of course we made, even in my childhood, we made like toys from newspapers. For example, we took newspapers in mailbox, we stole it from other like apartments mailboxes, and we just fire these airplanes. We made airplanes, we fire them with matches or lighter, and we like just launch them from the last floor. And now I think it was so stupid idea, because it could go, for example, to someone's open window, you know. So we were very like, we shouldn't do it, but we were like crazy childs. It was nothing to do on the street, so we tried to make fun, you know. But I understand it's stupid. Yes, and I just didn't tell you a lot of other things. For example, you can use it as a filler for cats' toilets, and still people use it like that. If some like table is shaking, you can put it on the, you know, if the floor is not straight, you can put it like under the table to stabilize the table, and so on and so on and so on. So the newspapers were like, were the very important thing in USSR. I didn't even think about it, but really. And let's give a tribute to the newspaper. And the world now turns to paper again, so from plastic. And subscribe to my channel, and I'm launching this Buran spacecraft, USSR space program returns. And 3, 2, engine sequence start. 1, engines at maximum thrust, and liftoff.